Hello, Mac enthusiasts and Hackintosh enthusiasts. This is me, and I'm going to be showing you how to install OS X on a PC. This is an AMD Phenom quad core. Put it on an XFX motherboard, which is an Enforce chipset, 750A, and it runs wonderful. I can render files quickly. And that's the whole point of the quad core processor. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on the computer and highlight some of the things you need to get this going. So here we are, I'm going to turn this on here. And it starts up. I'm going to pause the screen to show you the post screen. This is actually a, if you noticed, pause, hello, thank you. Now, notice, if you can see that, it is a AMD Phenom 9500 quad-core processor, 2.21 gigahertz, count 4 cores, and the RAM is at 800, or the bus speed is at 800 megahertz. So what I'm going to do is boot this up. From the USB stick that I have here, it's right down here. I got it plugged into a wire going to the back of the computer, and we're going to boot that up. And I've prepared it so it will install OS X. It's ready to boot OS X install disk, and you can find the details for that under my video here. And so here we go. Now here's the menu that comes up, and I don't know if you can see that. This is actually picking up all my hard drives in my computer. This already has an operating system. We're going to wipe it out so I can show you how easy this is. But we want the Mac install USB. You can't really read it right there, but that's it, in fact. And we're going to hit the space bar and do dash V so we can see behind the Apple logo, see behind the scenes. So I've hit the space bar with the Mac OS X install highlighted, and if you notice in the corner down here, I've put dash V, and what that does is verbose mode, and that will let us see what's going on. Here we go. So here it is booting up. We've got all kinds. It looks kind of like Linux. That's, in fact, that's what it's based off. Let's see if I can frame this a little better. There we are. This is normally what goes behind a boot up on a computer, and stuff that you normally don't see. And but that's what it looks like, and here we are on the Mac OS X install menu, the first menu. So that has all been loaded from this little USB stick on the desk there. So now what we're going to do is we're going to click the little continue arrow and format our partition our hard drive here. So go down here, click this. It's going to bring up Mac OS X install, and we want to go to utilities and do disk utility. Now, what we're going to do, this has all my disks in the system here. And what we want to do is format the hard drive for Snow Leopard. And what we're going to do is just click on the 160 drive, which already has it on there, but we're going to wipe it out. We're going to partition it here with one partition. And we're going to name it Snow, just because I can. And we're going to make sure that the options are GUID partition table. This is, it says here to use an Intel-based Mac, which this is, even though it's an AMD. And then we're going to say apply. This will wipe it out. And here you can see, I don't know if you can see this, but this is the, that's actually the USB stick there that's been pre-customized to boot up with this system. This is just my Windows hard drive here. That's, we just ignore that. But here we're going to do this. Oops, I clicked out of it. Looks like I'm going to do it again. One partition. Snow. Where is it? There it is. Snow and options GUID partition maps. Okay. And what else was there? I was going to say something else about this. Well, I don't know. Once you say apply, it pretty much just does it. Oh, yes. Mac OS Extended Journal. Do you want to leave it on that, too? So we say apply, we say partition. It goes. It's real exciting. It makes a little progress bar on the bottom. Unmounting disk. And it looks like I'm still crooked here. Can't stand crooked things. I'm trying to straighten them up as much as possible. Does that look a little better? It's because we're a bit of an angle, I think. Oh, well. Anyway. There, it's partition complete. We can close out disk utility up here. Disk utility quit, and we're ready to rock and roll, so to speak. Right, so here we hit continue. We agree to the license Apple agreement, because if you don't agree, you can't continue. We're going to check the Snow drive, and we're going to customize, okay? And we're going to do a couple little things here. Right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to check Rosetta and QuickTime 7 and uncheck language translations, because we only speak English anyway. And look, it saves 1.21 gigabytes of space. And the printer support, we don't really need that because, well, we're going to download any drivers we have in our system anyway. So we don't really need, what is it? It says 2.93 gigabytes of printer drivers. We don't need every printer driver in the world installed on a system. So we're going to take that off. We're going to say okay. So here we got additional fonts. I like fonts, so I'm going to do that. I like X11. I like Rosetta. That helps things like Final Cut work. And the old QuickTime, the old good old QuickTime 7. You got to have that because that's when QuickTime was actually better. And okay, and install. When we do install, this is going to take anywhere from 20 minutes to an hour or 45 minutes, depending on your system. In this case, it's going to be about, well, we'll find out. Here we go. Let's see, where's my watch? Where's my phone? Well, it's about 8:45 now, and I will get back when it's finished. Just a recap here. I've started the install about 3 minutes ago at about 8:47. And if you notice my clock here, oh wait, it's 8:51 now, so it's been about 3-4 minutes, and we're about halfway there, so I just wanted to give you a recap, and I'll give you a final when we're done. It's been approximately 6 or so minutes, whatever, 54 is, that's how long it's been, and look, we're about 3/4 done. Soon it will be finished and we'll be able to take over the world. It'll be glorious. And we will laugh at certain big companies that we won't mention, but we will say to them, look, I've installed it on the same hardware, well, virtually the same hardware that's on what you're selling at your store. And, well, not to be mocking or anything, but basically, if you feeling bad about having a Hackintosh, just, you know, after you got it running and you see that it runs well, just simply go to your local Best Buy or Mac store and, you know, inquire of an iMac if you could try one out and just see what it does, and then you'll feel better about your Hackintosh. Because really, there's no difference. It runs about the same, and if not faster. So, just my 2 cents. Interesting thing happened to me the other day. I was at the corner market trying to buy some grapefruits, and this lady came up to me. Just out of the blue, and she had mentioned something about cheesecakes, and I couldn't understand why she was talking about cheesecakes on a fruit stand, and then we inquired, of course, what kind of cheesecakes, and then she said, cherry cheesecakes, of course, and then I understood she was there for the cherries. So in fact, there were cherries on this particular market stand outside there. in Johannesburg, and so we picked cherries together and talked about cheesecake, and it was wonderful. Wonderful lady. She hailed from Liverpool, and she had in fact met the Beatles at one time, and knew Paul McCartney personally. I guess I don't know if it's true, but she was a wonderful lady. We just struck up this random conversation about cheesecake and the Beatles, and it was just fantastic. I loved it, and. I've never seen her again. I wonder if she was an angel, if she just appeared in this, you know, entertaining angels sort of thing, kind of mysterious, you know. And so anyway, yeah. Oops, I was out getting coffee, and apparently it, I don't know if this is an accurate time, but it's now 9 o'clock, which took about, 20 so minutes. It's restarting. First reboot. We're going to reboot to the RAM stick, of course, again, because the hard drive's not bootable yet. We have to do a few things to it, but here it's shutting down, and looks like the install was a success, and I wish I would have caught that screen. I was out actually outside there for a sec, and here we are on first reboot after installed to the hard drive. We're going to boot up from the USB stick again, but this time it's going to be we're going to choose the Snow Leopard, which the snow drive that we partitioned earlier. So here we are, booting from the USB stick. It's going to give us a menu, and we're going to choose Snow on the right here. Again, I'm going to do verbose mode, spacebar, dash V, right? And here we are, first boot. But we're going to say continue. We can identify the keyboard, so identifying the keyboard. We're saying continue, and here we are on the welcome setup screen. United States, US. Do not transfer my information. I do have an Apple ID, but I'm not going to use it here. This is just a test, so we're going to make a test user. Test user, 1234 5th Street. Pick a city, Boulder, Colorado. Boulder. Colorado, and I believe that's 80501, or that might be, not sure. Me at you.com. 555, just like in the movies, 555-555. And we are not going to school because we're idiots. So, here we are. Primarily, we use this computer for. Are we recording? Yes, we are. We use it for home, and it doesn't. Who cares what we use it for? We're just going to use it, all right? We don't want to stay in touch because they don't really care, and we don't really care. So we're going to sign up a password, a really hard one to memorize. Double space bar. We're going to continue, and it says, "Oh, you shouldn't do that." But for the password hint, double space. We're going to continue. It creates the account, and. Boom, we're in. Now this is the first time. Oh, it looks like we're on safe boot though. It's very strange that it would do safe boot. Never done this before. Interesting. Right, well, I guess this would work in safe boot as well as any. I don't know why it did that. We'll go to the RAM stick here. This is the one that we made earlier. The link is below the video. We do view list. And now we need to install Chameleon to the Snow drive, so it'll allow it to boot up. So we're going to go, I've put them on the stick already, it's right here. Double click this, Chameleon 5, continue. And it's already going to put it on Snow, that's what we want it on. And we say continue, install, we put our big double space in there, continue the installation, and there it goes. And it wants to log out, but we're not going to log out because I want to do a couple more things. My monitors are backwards. So anyway, let's fix the monitors real quick. I have double monitors set up here. Displays, and this one is in fact on the right of the one. There we go. Ah, much better. Show all. Now, for the Snow drive. We have no legacy file here, or boot file. The Chameleon didn't install this boot file, so we don't need to worry about that. But we have a legacy kernel on the RAM stick here. This will make our hard drive bootable. And we're going to copy the extra folder as well. The extra folder is from the RAM stick. Copy it to the Snow drive. That should let us boot up. It's from a working XFX Enforce motherboard Hackintosh setup. So that is working. And then if we want to put the system file, these are audio drivers, and this ensures USB and networking as well into the system folder. But for grins, we won't put those in there now. We'll just go ahead and reboot and see if it boots up on the hard drive. So I'm going to shut down. Boink. Oh, and look, we've got a big, long, huge thing we can choose from. Snow drive, we got our Windows drive, we have our USB stick. We're going to go to the Snow again, just for grins, to see if it's changed. Might not. Sometimes it changes, sometimes it don't. Here we are, booting back into the Snow Leopard drive. These first couple of boots, it's writing the cache files and, making the hard drive, it'll be booting faster next go around. So there's our typical USB errors. And it looks like it might have mounted the... Yes, it mounted our drive. We didn't have to go into Windows, so that's good. And we're going to install the latest update. I actually have it on here. Tools. Actually, it's not in Tools. It's in Updates. It's View List. Very hard to see huge icons like that. Updates. And here we have 6.6, 6.5, and 6.7. I'm not sure if we can do 6.7 just yet. Let's try and see. If that is the case, we'll just go ahead and do 6.7 and bypass the other two. It'll tell us if it needs another thing. I'm sure, okay, it looks like it's going to work. Continue. Yes, indeed, 6.7. It's going to take 1.99 gigabytes of space. Well, do you really have a choice? It's a combo update. Spacebar, here we go! Continue the installation. There it goes. Might take a few minutes to install that. In the meantime, I'm gonna grab another cup of Joe. I'll return shortly. It's wrapping up. The hard drive's definitely clicking away. It's not locked up by anything. It is in fact running the package scripts as we speak. Oh, it's registering the updated applications. I'm sure that's putting on the fancy new App Store, and the new iTunes, and what have you. I don't know how many updates are going to be coming out. I know Lion is coming out this summer. That's going to be a whole new animal. sorry about the pun, but it's going to be 10.7. So I know Mac tends to do updates up to a point, and then they don't do updates like for... regular Leopard, it was 10.5.8 was the highest they went, and that was it. For Tiger, it was 10.4.11, and that was it. And this may be it for Snow Leopard, 10.6.7. They might even do 10.6.8, because that would coincide with 10.5.8. That would make total Apple sense. And here we're going to restart. Here we go. You ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1, restart. Here we go. So here we are, rebooting once again on the Mac, and cross your fingers. Now, here we are on boot post again, once again, Phantom 9500 quad core, speed 202 gigahertz, count 4 cores, 800 bus size. And here we are, 3, 2, 1, boom. There's our Snow. We're going to do a dash V to see if in fact 10.6.7 does update. Here we go. Looks like we're booting up okay in whatever this is, 10.6.7, and we have a mouse. Look at that, the USB ports are working. Wow, okay. We still don't have sound, and we most in fact don't have network. That'll be last, of course. And oh look, we've got the fancy little App Store icon now. We can go Apple crazy and buy all kinds of applications, and it looks like our USB ports do in fact work, so we don't need to mess with USB drivers. Let's go to our about this Mac. And oh my gosh, look at that, 10.6.7. We are March 23rd, completely updated to 10.6.7. It is in fact telling us that our processors are 2.2 gigahertz Intel core, but don't tell no one. 4 gigahertz 1600 DDR30. If we go to more info, we have more info, and who cares? It all works. Now let's, what are we going to do? Oh yes, let's get the last, let's get some sound and network so we can surf the net and tell people how, in fact, cool we are. Right, so I'm going to show you a couple little commands to do this. You need to, actually I'm going to steal from Snow, I copied this over earlier. We are going to want, wrong way. We've got to go to system, and we have to go into the IO networking family, show package contents, and plugins. And here's all the different kinds of network cards that was used on my system before. And I'm going to actually go to the system library extensions. This is where all the Mac drivers are installed, in fact. And we're going to go to the networking family, show contents, plugins, and compare the two. And I believe the one that we're looking for is Apple Yukon 2. This is what makes my particular network work. Now this one has that, but it doesn't work. So I'm wondering if we grab the right one. I'm going to make a backup folder here, just in case I want to back up something. Copy that over here. Move to trash. And I want to get a terminal window open. And the reason being you need a terminal is because cool people use terminals. So I try to be as cool as possible. Now, we're going to do a sudo -s. That gives us, we are super powerful now. We can do anything we want to our system. And we're going to do a couple commands here. We're going to drop this Yukon in here, authenticate, spacebar. Now we're going to do chown -r root colon wheel. And then we're going to do it to the extensions folder. Extensions, actually that's the one we want to fix. That gives us some network. chmod -r755 to the same directory, the extensions folder. I'm going to touch it. Don't know what that does really, but it's cool. Now we're going to exit. Close terminal. Here we are on a reboot after installing the network Yukon 2 text into the extensions IO networking family. And if you noticed here, I don't know if you can see this, it's actually in put the driver in. Yukon 2 Marvel Yukon Gigabit Adapter, that's what's on the XFX motherboard, and it looks like it installed it. So we should have internet when we're booted up here. And then we'll do the audio, and we'll be finished. We can start using our happy Hackintosh. All right, here we are back for a third reboot, this time for the audio driver. We're going to see if, in fact, the audio driver will work on this boot. I've installed it in the system extensions folder, which is in the root system library extensions, and we'll see what it does. It might do something, it might not. I don't know. Here we go. Boink. That's a good sign. Oh, it looks like oh my goodness, look at that. It works, great. Now, we got audio. Let's check it out and see how it sounds, right? So we're gonna go to just a test site real quick. Go to GrooveShark. GrooveShark.com. And we'll pick a song. I have a Billy Joel song stuck in my brain. Don't ask me why. We're going to search for Billy Joel. Don't ask me why. Right. Here we go. Bad audio, eh?
All your life you had to stand in line. Still you're standing on your feet. Oh, your choice made you change your mind. Now your calendar's complete. Don't wait for answers. Take a chance. Don't ask me why.
Here comes the new software. Updates! Thank you for watching this goofy tutorial. We try to make things fun around here because life can be so drab at times. And remember, if you meet a lady at the market buying cherries, ask her, is it for cheesecake? Thank you.